We're at the Holiday Inn in Erie. There's really not much to see. A couple of trains. Bambi. Bambi the dancer. And we've been here a couple of days. Job's nasty. A 3.5 hour flight in. Jim and I are here. It just snowed. We have like a blizzard. Still seems to come on and off. Oh well. It is a big job. Here is a big prison. Here's our wonderful arrangements at the Holiday Inn. Yeah, so. Really kind of small. I mean, he left my door open yesterday with the computers and everything. There's me. Yeah. Rough and tough prison maker. Just a shower. Tiny fucking bathroom. Alright.
Now.
Cool,
we getting
man.
A foot of snow today.
Uh-huh.
We got about 3 inches last night.
Uh-huh.
We're getting about a foot today.
Okay. Where we all at?
We're in Erie. We're going down to the job in Allegheny County.
Okay.
And yesterday was no snow. Today we got in a blizzard. And the job's a mud job. And
it's a mob. And can we do a recording?
Just doing all the recording.
That way you can don't see my face there.
But you say this
place? Yeah.
Yeah. So you don't break the land. Alright, where do we hit the corn?
Oh man.
This is a good side, yeah.
Cool.
On sale. That's right, everything, including all pictures, mirrors,
running into Main Street, Albion now.
At 1/3 off. And a new ship.
See all the jungle. Tree. Couple cars. No people walking around.
The finest names and furniture, including the new Berkline electric massage recliner.
A lot of plenty of snow.
Just for stopping in, all adults. get to reach in the special anniversary cake, and everyone wins. And now is the time to lay away your Christmas gifts.
Seven. Brian Adams begins another half-hour music mix on Mix 103.7. Have yourself a good Saturday, Jeff Barrett next.
Say something, Bob.
We're heading up to Albion site.
The trailer up office. Our trailer all the way on the back there. Close, see the power there? Lend the trailer around. Too some muddy and wet. A lot of snow. That's the toilet. Got it winged up now. Yesterday, today, they're coming up. Cool, man. Okay. That's one of the buildings. We come to our trailer very soon. One of the buildings has to be turned on. L3 housing unit, I think. And this is Bob.
Hi.
The handsome guy with a sunglass on. I'm ready to go to work. Here we come to the office.
Mass equipment.
Ooh, look cool.
All right, we're in the trailer. Here's our panel. We're here a little late, so everybody's probably out in the buildings. Panels look nice. There's B. There's Jim's seat right there. Nobody takes that seat. Here's our drawings. Alright. Hey, we're at L3.
Hey, how many construction workers can you fit in the mechanical room?
It depends on how lovely they are.
Yeah, it depends on how cold it is outside.
Go ahead. Just so quick, get the hard hat on.
It's Tim.
There's Tim.
Hi.
Hi.
Gary. And I'm sorry, I didn't get your name, Chief.
Ernie.
Ernie, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Okay. We're in L3, and this is our mechanical room, and dives are working, powering everything up. Oh, yeah. That's good. That's right. Don't look at the camera. Don't smile.
We'll go up the stairs. We're coming in the back way. Looks like we're on the mezzanine level. Telling us about a story where they pull out the razor wire and it's really like slinky. Some guy let go and it wrapped around the guy. The worst he got was 30 stitches. You just don't move. In this observatory room, looking down at the dorm, there's a console where a machine will be, and that's the one side. We're going to go down and take a look. Okay.
Yeah, you can see there's showers. Two floor, mezzanine level. See they use drywall for the ceiling. Just screw it right in. Two levels. These are worm-like locks. Low voltage locks. So they don't pop. They kind of like squiggle. See the cool big posts. There'll be the guard station out in the open. I'm surprised that they have us in here actually so early, because There's really still heavy construction, dirt all over the floor. This isn't even close to being complete. Let's take a look at one of the cells.
Different, not hinged with a DPS, there's a magnetized DPS there. Of course, she's got the bolt. Isn't this the strangest of cells? Here we have pretty clear mirrors, these metal mirrors. You can see they've got grates, like Frank Morris used to escape. So these just go to the next cell or to the pipe chase. Normal sinks, push button hot and cold. Normal toilet, with a push button flush. This is different, apparently it's a two-man cell. And apparently they're gonna have lockers. And I would guess they would have locks as well. Really strange. A little table for a desk, and your bed. You've got a little rack with hooks. The light switch with an actual light. And you'll notice that we also have cable, an electric socket, another electric socket. This is better than some apartments. Here's the call switch. This actually looks like a neat call switch. For a medium to high security prison, most of the other prisons I've ever worked on, this is unheard of. You'll notice it's actually metal plates. When they come loose,
definite danger. Even those hooks, I'm sure they could eventually break one of those hooks off.
Yeah, definite danger.
Yo! 250 a pack, man. Bad news. Should be the Marlboro man in Taiwan.
You don't smoke?
Yeah.
You die anyway.
Yeah.
From pollution.
Mm-hmm.
So, you enjoy the best you can. And, I call the doctor next week.
Mm-hmm. Side. Again, this is all L3, which is what we're down here to, make work. And, they've actually got some neat facilities in this prison, which we're going to check out in a little bit. All right, there are all the other dorm units, the other L3s, and this is Prison Industries, the chapel. Actually, the chapel's pretty nice. It's got a cool seat on the other side. It's got a big hole in it. It's like stained glass kind of deal. But you don't see too much going on. We're going up here. Here's all the kitchens. And here's the chapel. It's all pretty nice, actually. With a tower in the background. While the mud's hiding it, every time you step, there's 8 inches of mud. All over the place. This is the kitchen. This is all kitcheny kind of stuff. All under construction. You can see this one's still under heavy duty construction. Check out the block. It's kind of cool. This is special cinder block. And it's got a porcelain coating on it, so that food and stuff doesn't get absorbed in. Let's look around. Stairway, it's pretty steep. Getting up to the top. We're in the kitchen area now. I guess this will be some sort of prep area. A pipe cutter of some sort. Let's see. In here, it looks like some sort of mixer. Look at this. This is a fridge or something. I'm going to open it up. So be careful because they don't have the safety latches. Can you see in there? Kind of dark. But it is huge.
Here is refrigerators, an oven.
construction prep area. See if we can take a look in one. Can you see how deep there is? Can you see it? It must be 50 feet deep by 20 feet wide. And there's a bunch of them. Serious mud here. And this is good. We're going to check up here. Maybe we'll hit some of the medical building. Actually, it was pretty boring. Back, ain't much happening. For a nicer day. Fire plug. Inside the chapel. There's a big heating duct. This will end up being a nice chapel. You see, we highlight the brick in red. They use the glass block all over. But here it's kind of nice. See what's over here. And it's all ice all over. I can barely walk. Huh. Take a look in. Sounds like I hear those heaters. It's gotta be 30 degrees and my fingers are getting frostbitten. See, they use the metal studs now. They seem to be pretty strong. And they got the corrugated metal roofs. See, there's water all over. Conduit. The way I understand it is we run the conduit, sewage, and all those things underneath. Leave stubs for the conduit runs. Put down a concrete floor, slab. And then, at which point, either depending on how the construction goes,
bring up your concrete or your iron work, your heavy duty iron, like beams like right there. Run all those, put in your frames, the electricians on the wiring. Keep in mind, concrete's gotta be solid. It has to be filled. Unless you're gonna tear down the prison. And that's already happened. Think of Palm Beach. Very top. These look like the heating ducts and returns for the heating system. This looks like it here. We'll see later on the water boilers and such for the other buildings are incredibly massive. We didn't get to see them yet. We'll see it next trip. And I saw them the other day at Gary's. See, and they blow right out. So, heavy duty action. Look at the serious venting. That, I think, is the hot water heater for L3, which is a housing unit, which has the cells downstairs, which basically all it has is the cells downstairs, and I think it's about 128 cells, each cell with a sink and a toilet, and it's got about 16 showers. That is one huge hot water heater. Yeah, it definitely looks like the hot water. I can't think of what else it could be. Yeah, it's definitely hot water for the heating system as well. Look at those rooms. Yeah, see? Looks like hot water sending it to you. Huge. Just huge. This thing's gotta be like 15 feet tall. I mean, here's the door. Hey, we're in Presque Isle State Park. There's a little strip, an island up into Lake Erie. This is basically what we're looking at, Lake Erie. Like a 30-minute drive or something before we get to the airport. Falling on my head like a memory, falling on my head.
wildlife.
The best mix of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. Erie's Mix 103.7.
J&J Travel and Tours is doing it again. This Wednesday, the 18th, J&J Travel and Tours is bringing the Carnival Cruise representative to Erie. That's right, one night and one night only. This Wednesday at Raymond's Restaurant at 7:30 p.m. Limited seating is available and reservations are required. So call J&J Travel and Tours now to secure your place. The Carnival Cruise rep will be offering fantastic winter specials. But you must call J&J Travel and Tours for reservations. Don't miss this night. Carnival Cruise Night at Raymond's Restaurant at 7:30 p.m. Reservations are required. Call 452-4682. That's 452-4682. Call now. J&J Travel and Tours.
Imagine if you treated all your health problems the way an alcohol and drug user treats addiction.
Why does everybody make such a big deal? I mean, it's just a broken leg. Look, I'm going to do something about it after the holidays, I promise.
Every so often I overdo it a little bit, and maybe I have a little angina attack. You know, chest pain afterward. But hey, that just tells me it's time to slow down, you know.
So I run a fever every day. It's only 102 degrees, and hey, I can handle it.
Alcohol and drug dependency is nothing to shrug off. It's a disease, but it can be treated. The Serenity Center for Addiction Treatment offers effective treatment for alcohol and drug dependency.
Here, we'll get some decent shot of Lake Erie.
Sunshine and a high both days right near 40 degrees. Right now in Erie, kind of a dismal, gray, breezy 44 degrees. You just might want to stand out in that breeze, though. Paula Abdul is blowing kisses in the wind to kick off our next half hour music mix. Erie's best variety of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. Mix 103.7.
side lake over there.
Thank you.
definitely look man-made. They are man-made.
Sure, you're listening to Mix 103.7 coming up this Wednesday morning between 6 and 10 a.m. That to win a pair of tickets to see Bryan Adams and Mr. Big at the Civic Center coming up November 25th. Now, when we play a Bryan Adams song, callers number 3 and 7 will each win a pair of tickets to the concert. That's beginning this Wednesday morning between 6 and 10. Listen for your chance to win from Mix 103.7.
Jenny's out to the right.
Lake to pose.
It's like an ocean. It's actually a lake. Toronto's on the other side.
Strike to pose.
Everything you can do.
Toyota.
Cars poking in all over the place.